day, everyone. Today, I'm bringing you to the famous Disney story, Kung Fu Panda, the master of disasters. Hi-ya! Or not. Master Shifu had a clumsy, disastrous student named Po. One day, Po was named the legendary dragon warrior, and that made Master Shifu scowl. How was he supposed to train this big, clumsy panda into a kung fu warrior who could protect the Valley of Peace? First, Po started training with a friendly-looking training dummy. Po hit the dummy as hard as he could. Whap! It bounced back and sent him flying into the gauntlet. This is hopeless, thought Master Shifu. He couldn't even win a battle against a training dummy. How could he ever become a kung fu master? Upon giving up, Master Shifu found Po stuffing his face with food inside the bunkhouse. He was surprised to see him perform amazing kung fu to get to the treats. He decided to test him again. "There's a jar of cookies on the top shelf," Shifu said to Po. Without any thought, Po jumped 10 feet off the ground. He landed in a perfect full split pose. "How did you do that?" asked Master Shifu. "I don't know," replied Po. "I was just trying to get the cookie." Master Shifu discovered the secret to training Po. Food! The next day, he revealed his new training plan to Po. "I cannot train you the way I have trained the five. I must use this." Master Shifu held out a steaming bowl of dumpling. "Awesome! I'm hungry," said Po hungrily. Po reached for the bowl, but Master Shifu was too quick. Twah! The old master smacked Po with his staff. Po fell flat on his face. "Ayak! When you have trained, then you may eat," instructed Master Shifu. First, they worked on Po's stance. Master Shifu taught Po how to face off against an opponent, taunting him with the reward of delicious dumplings. Next, they practiced Po's kicks. When Po snatched the bowl of soup, Master Shifu charged at him with his bamboo staff. But Po blocked him with a well-placed spin kick. Hi-ya! Po was learning a lot. "After you, Panda," said Master Shifu, holding up a bowl of dumplings. Po grabbed one of the dumplings, but just as he was about to put it in his mouth, whoosh! Master Shifu snatched the dumpling and ate it himself. "Hey!" protested Po. But he quickly understood. This was a test. It was time for Po to put all his moves together if he wanted to eat any of those delicious dumplings. Po readied his chopsticks, and so did Master Shifu. Without any warning, Po spun his left foot and delivered a mighty kick. Hi-ya! After a well-fought battle, Po grabbed the last dumpling. Master Shifu smiled. Po had a dragon warrior in himself after all. He just needed to believe in himself. You have done well, Panda, praised Master Shifu. Done well? I have done awesome! Thank you, Master, said Po with a bow. Yes, you have done awesome, Shifu said, bowing back, as he smiled for the first time. So, the moral of the story, guys, never give up in believing in yourself. All of us have the potential in us, and sometimes we just need the right way to inflict that potential. Wait, the question is, have you found yours? With that, I end my story here. Thank you.
Thank you.